Once an ancient practice passed on by spiritual leaders with lifetimes of dedication, mindfulness can now be taught by an accredited teacher who's paid for a two-day course. And after being catapulted into modernity, it's being sold for billions. So, has something sacred been co-opted by capitalism? Or is it actually a good thing more people are trying to be mindful? Mindfulness is everywhere. Mindful parenting, mindful eating, mindful politics, mindful business leadership, mindful soldiers. It's part of a wellness industry worth billions each year. We're told mindfulness reduces stress, anxiety, depression, blood pressure. But let's look at the downsides, the science backing its benefits, and the monetization of mindfulness. In a world where we can barely use a toilet roll without having a scroll, where we're multitasking like no one's business, we probably need some time out. And what could possibly go wrong when finally left alone with our thoughts?
If you're feeling a bit anxious and you then sort of put a magnifying lens on all of those experiences, for some people, it just makes everything a lot worse.
Dr. Nicholas Van Dam estimates up to 10% of people will have an adverse experience.
People can have psychotic episodes. People have massive increases in sense of suicidality.
They don't put that in the fine print. The benefits, on the other hand, are outlined in bold. And is the science backing those benefits? Well, kind of. Mindfulness hasn't been studied for as long as it's been practiced, so scientific evidence is lacking. Dr. Van Dam's work found many of the studies claiming benefits were poorly designed, with inconsistent definitions and very few control groups. In short, benefits were being oversold and the side effects undersold. But he says there is evidence that can make you feel less stressed, help with various mental illnesses, and even pain. But
most of the evidence that we have is based on either extremely experienced meditators or people who've done a fairly rigorous and structured, systematic course of training.
I guess it's kind of like exercise. We know the benefits, but you're not going to see them after a two-day boot camp. That hasn't stopped mindfulness workshops popping up everywhere, from Google to the Army. What's now been dubbed McMindfulness was once part of the Buddha's Noble Eightfold Path. With right mindfulness also came right view, right conduct, right effort, right speech, and so on. And Buddha definitely didn't charge for his teachings. Mindfulness is not an end in itself, it's a path to enlightenment. But divorced from that, it's kind of like a sniper.
They're very aware of their surroundings. They have to be perfectly aware of the wind, the environment, what the moisture in the air. They know exactly what's going on in their body. They know their heartbeat.
Put them in an MRI, a sniper and a monk won't look that different. But, and it is a very big but, a sniper's end goal is to kill someone. And Dr. Van Dam says therein lies the rub. Mindfulness should be about compassion and harmony, not just coping with stress better.
It's really about motivation. I think it's a lot. Boils down to, why are you doing this? Are you doing this to make the world a better place?
It's a bit of a grey area when companies like HSBC Bank or Facebook or Google get on the bandwagon. Buddhist monk Gelong Tubden has worked with all of those companies.
I'm not interested in the company's profits, but I'm interested in human happiness. I feel that that is a kind of social work. Sometimes their approach might be, well, this is going to help us to work with greater efficiency and that will help the company's profits, but that's not actually the main reason for meditating.
He says mindfulness isn't the property of Buddhism and thinks it's a good thing that more people are doing it, as long as it comes from a place of compassion and the will to help others. If we can build a daily practice around that, whether it's in an ashram or on a paid app, then surely that can only be a good thing.
Hey, if you enjoyed that, make sure you subscribe to the Feed's YouTube channel.
And you can watch these videos here. See you next time.